going to turn it into a hot summer night. Come on, man.
Yeah.
this very hour. We had last night off. If you could have seen him last night, you would swear to God there was no way he could be standing up here tonight. I give you Mr. Michael Anthony. One more time, this one. Fucking great, yeah. everybody one thing. It's fucking great to be playing for a great audience. It makes your whole life wonderful. Edward, hey, we gotta find out what's going on here. Now, why are you guys fucking with these people? What are they doing wrong? Are they taking pictures? That's all they're doing? Edward, should we let them take pictures of us tonight? What do you think? I don't give a fuck. I guess it's a building bonus. But anyway, forget all the troubles, man. Just everybody just cut loose and have a good time. This next song is written about one of my favorite people in the world, man. I was watching TV while we were recording OU812, right? And so I'm looking for some lyrics for this next song, you know? And on comes my man, my favorite guy in the world, Mr. Jimmy Swagger. Come on, let's have a hand for Mr. Jimmy Swagger. That lion motherfucker, man, he's on TV, right? So I'm thinking to myself, now he ain't never done nothing wrong. He didn't do nothing I ain't done. He ain't done nothing we ain't never done. He might, you know, smoke a little reefer, maybe. You know, do a couple lines or two. Throw him a fucking couple tricks, right? That's what we're doing. Problem is he claims to be a man of God, see? And so he says that shit's bad, right? But he's out there doing it. So I thought to myself, you know, if you can't trust the religious leaders in the world, then who the fuck can you trust, right? That's a simple question. So I figure when it all comes down, only person you can trust is yourself. If you think it's right, and if it makes you happy, go on and do it. If you think it's wrong, don't fucking do it. Here's a song called Thank you. seen since my last hometown. So anyway, this is your video. we started thinking to ourselves, you know, we're going to have to shoot a new video eventually. And we thought, well, what song do we want to do? So rather than go, well, so it's what happened, instead of saying, well, let's make a video of the newest single, we said, fuck it, let's make a video that will be the most fun to make, right? So we made a video that just feels out of ball making. And when you get a look at the bitches in this video, oh, I swear to God, man, I hate to stand up here and sound like a sexist, but these are some of the best looking tits and butts I've ever seen. And let it be known that the band auditioned every one of them. So here's a real fun song, okay? And you'll be seeing this video pretty soon. It's called Come On Baby. It's about to start. We'll be right back. you the whole story now. See, here's the way the whole story goes. We were on a tour a couple months ago. So we were on a tour a few months ago called The Monsters of Rock, and I see some shirts out there. So I guess we got about 15,000 people here. I gotta warn all 15,000. If you see somebody walking around with a monster t-shirt on, don't fuck with them. They're crazy. That was the longest, most intense, toughest goddamn rock and roll show that ever fucking went anywhere in the world. What happened is you had to sit through about 9 hours of rock and roll before we even came on the stage. And by the time we came on the stage, anybody that was left out there that had any energy left were true fucking rock and roll crazy maniacs. So I don't know how many of you people actually saw the Monster Tour? I should say thank you or I'm sorry. Which one was it? No, it was tough because I guess the nearest place we played around here was maybe Boston. Foxborough. And it was so fucked up. Not the show, but they fucked us around so bad because originally we were supposed to play two nights there, and then they said, no, you can't play at all. The city said, you can't play here at all. And so we said, so we had to hire a lawyer to sue the goddamn city to get some money, right? So then they said, okay, well, we don't want a lawsuit. So they let us play, but they said, you can only play one night, and you can only have 50. The place held about 70,000. They said, you can only have 50,000 people, that's all. And they put up, I don't know if anybody was there, you remember those speed bumps? They put up human speed bumps. These bullshit things, big cement things about this tall, all throughout the place, so that you couldn't run from one end to the other. And if you did, you'd fall and get fucking smashed because the rest of people would jump over. Anyways, that was a show that was really kind of, it wasn't the right thing. They made us take team and come off the show. They said they can only be 4 hours long. They made all these bullshit rules. To make a long story short, that's why we came back through here, so that we can do our whole show. We're gonna play 4 hours ourselves tonight. Fuck it. About 2.5 hours. We got at least another hour or so to go, so just don't get a pain. Here's a great song. Here's a song called When It's Love. think that was no. This next song, as everybody knows, it's, there's somebody here tonight that's seen this band for the first time, is there? It is a cover. Well, as everybody knows, everybody in this band takes a solo section. And so it's my turn now, and I don't know what to do. You know, the guy I get in this band, I'm going to sit here and play guitar for you. And so I'm going to sing a song that I wrote on the last solo album I did. And Eddie actually produced the album with me and played bass. He's a badass bass player, too, the fuck up the room. If he could sing, I'd kill him. But, this song's kind of special because it's about a very serious subject. Almost too serious because I don't even know quite exactly what I was trying to say. But about 4 o'clock in the morning one night in the high desert, I was just thinking about things. And everybody looks for a place and a time when you feel really good inside, you know what I mean? When you just feel like everything's okay, you shut the world out, and you just say, hey, I love feeling like this. And I thought to myself, that's probably the way a baby would feel inside his mother's stomach before it gets woken up to this big crazy world. It probably feels great in there, right? So I tried to write a song about being born, and I call this song this place, I call this special place that I've been maybe twice in my life in my head, that very secret place I call it where eagles fly. And I wrote this song about it. Sunday morning, 9 a.m. I saw fire in the sky. I felt my heart pounding in my chest. I heard an eagle cry.
Yeah.
special song. Thank you very much. Well, we do have some other problems in the world. You know what? Like the speed limit, right?
Wow.
Reach out, touch it. Freddie Van Halen.
Thank you.
something we planted this like an inside joke. You're kind of a good looking woman there, Mom. But here's a t-shirt that I'm gonna take home. I'm gonna frame this. It says, I survived the monsters of rock, Oxford, Maine. Who threw this up there? Who threw it up there? Come on, who's the guy? Where's the guy? Who's the guy? Help me out now. Who threw this up there? You threw it up there, you swear to God you're the guy? Come on up here, Dad. Come on. I said they did it. One guy's bullshit. There's another one. Okay, where'd that shirt come from? That's from your buddy? This is the guy here? This is the guy? Fuck, there's about 20 of them. Fuck all of you guys. Let me just tell the story then. Mikey, get a six-pack of beer and pass it down to these motherfuckers. Here's what happened. Here's what happened. It was raining so fucking hard, two of our own guys got struck by lightning. It was the worst nightmare of all times. We had 47,000 people sold out when we came. The show, but by the time we came on, it was 5 hours later than we were supposed to come on. Only 2,000 people were left, and they stayed through that fucking show. And those 2,000 people are special people. I don't know, but those people know who they are, okay? And you're special people. It was a nightmare, and we played anyway, though, okay? Now before we get up, I want this shirt. Keep that, but before we get on, I also want to say one more thing. I think Eddie, Alex, and Michael will agree with me. This is about the 10th show. We've done about 10 or 12 shows since the Monsters. And we had one great, great, great show in Charlotte, North Carolina, of all places. We thought it was the best show that we had done, but tonight, honest to God, you people have been fucking great, man. It has been really a good show.